Started day four of what we did this morning. It was nice and peaceful and quiet. We went ahead and yesterday, as you saw, we got that wall plumbed up. And then we moved up to the roof. We needed to move some of these columns out a little bit. And we used the two bays of X bracing up here. Some buildings don't have X bracing, so come-alongs work as well. This building has so much bracing just because of the load. So now that we got everything plumb, we moved these columns, we're good. We went and we checked our base plate bolts. The next thing that we're gonna do, actually, we're gonna move a little bit ahead because we got some other help coming today. And we're gonna have them go in and tighten all of the purlin bolts, put in all of our lap bolts, and hang all of the flange bracing. But since the building's tight, square, and plumb, and all the bracing is good, bolts are tight on the floor. So we're gonna move on to the back wall here, maybe pull out a little bit of dirt away from the foundation to give us some room. And we're gonna snap a line along the base an inch and a half down to hold for our base trim. And we're gonna set our base trim down here. We're gonna do a cool mitered corner, but right now we're just gonna run it long, and we're gonna be able to start sheeting this wall today. So we'll probably start sheeting from that end, work in this direction. We've already got our 4-inch Zs installed. These 4-inch Zs, sometimes with a building with a rigid frame end wall or a hot rolled end wall, you'll find like a pile of these in the job box. And what these are for is so when we run the panel, we have something to screw the panel to on the corners and something to put the corner trim on as well. Right now, Garrett and the guys, they're gonna go in, tighten up all of these girts, and they're gonna make sure that they're in line with the steel line. While we're talking about that, I want to talk about steel line. I've threatened to do this in a lot of videos. I've hit on it a couple of times, just briefly. But when we talk about steel line, and when you see in your drawing steel line, what we're talking about is the edge of steel, right? Not the end of the panel, not the bolts. Basically, where the panel is going to meet the girt system, and right in line with the edge of the concrete. So all the way up. That is steel line. We have it on both walls. So steel line and steel line. This building doesn't have a concrete notch. It'd be nice if it did, but they did not do that. No big deal. We can still install the base trim. It just base trim attaches to the base channel or base angle. And the other thing, before we can sheet this wall, we're gonna have to bring in our 4x2 rake angles, which will run on top of the purlin. And it gives the very top of the wall sheet something to attach to, because you can't screw it in to the purlin there. After we get all that and we're, you know, sheeting or whatever, we do need to come back and install the eave struts, and there is a purlin that's being used as a strut. So once that's done, that's basically all of the structural steel except for the front. Hopefully this is helpful understanding what the steel line is and how we're gonna do base trim, but we'll make sure that Justin gets some good footage of the base trim going in for you guys. All right, thanks, see you in the next one.